going down, fuck the world, I'm a thug. Tell him Dana, stop me, but a slug. But I'm DJ real quick. And I know, Fred, you and I did a post-fight show right after the event. And we were talking about DJ. I mean, the record, is it impressive? I mean, it's an impressive record, right? But, you know, people are going to hit. They've been talking about this shit about how, you know, the opponents haven't been the highest caliber kind of guys. Let me ask you this. If Anderson Silva, let's go with this. Whose streak is more impressive, DJ's or Anderson Silva's 10 title defenses?
Is you asking me?
Yeah.
Is that even serious?
I'm just asking.
No, I don't think that DJ's is even close to as impressive as Anderson's, to be completely fucking honest with you. And you know what I love about this whole DJ Anderson thing? He hasn't really beat Anderson's record yet. Lest we forget, Travis Luter missed weight, so that fight didn't count. But Anderson won that fight. B, Anderson fought twice at 205 during that duration. So technically speaking, he beat his fucking title defense record, but he really hasn't won as many fights. Listen, what he did was super impressive, no doubt. But you cannot deny the fact that he did it in a fucking weight division in its infancy. 55 has been breeding killers since 92. 125 didn't fucking exist until like 3 years ago, man. DJ is the man, no doubt. But I think we find out how great DJ is when he goes up to 35 and he loses a little bit of maybe his strength or speed or whatever the fuck advantage. You know what I'm saying? And I get it. It's the George St. Pierre thing. If you're dominant at one weight class, why should you have to move up? Fair enough. I really don't have an answer for that. If he wants to stay at 125 and fight Jussier Formiga or fucking Cejudo again or fucking Diet Pettis, he can do whatever he wants, man. But the reality is, what's the only thing that's really going to boost him is going to 35 and taking on challenges that we think that he can't win. I mean, it kind of sucks. He's almost a victim of his own success at 25. But there's just nothing there for him to prove at 25 no more.
But Fred, let me ask you a question, though. Is this going to be enough for the finicky fans of MMA? I mean, honestly, like,
what do you mean?
What if he goes to 35? Or is the champion up there? Let's say it's Cody Garbrandt, right? He was dominant in 35 before. It's not to say that he's not going to be dominant again, but what is that going to prove to all the finicky fans? Oh, he went up. He beat some other guy that isn't as skilled as him. That's the excuse people are going to use. He's still a small guy. His record still doesn't stand. Blah, blah, blah. See, like, here's the thing. I get what you're coming from. And you know what? Your guys' show after the event, you made a great point. And I gotta like point everybody to that show, because Fred, you made a great point. If he really wants to go after being the best in the world, go after the only guy to beat you, which is Dominic Cruz.
And that's That's why I put that picture in our little post fight, or the preview thing for this fucking podcast. I put the stare down with him and Dominic. That's the only fight that matters for me for Mighty Mouse right now. That fight is so fun. Even if Dominic loses, sorry to cut you off, Jesse, but even if Dominic loses to Jimmy Rivera, I still want to see Dominic Cruz versus Mighty Mouse again. That would be as excited as I would have been for a Mighty Mouse fight, probably ever.
Bar none. And you know what? And there's nothing wrong with saying that. But I think I'm more pissed off at the fans that are like, well, he needs to move up to 35 and just dominate there. Let's see him dominate there. We know he can do that. We know
Do we know he can do that? He got ran out of 35 by Dominic Cruz like 5 years ago. I don't think we do know he can dominate 35. I think that's what makes it intriguing.
35 back then, when it was also in its infancy, when nobody was there, and he took on the guy that reigned supreme forever. But nobody wanted Dominic Cruz to move. And eventually got ushered out by the new generation. See, to me, like, if I were Mighty Mouse, I wouldn't care. I just keep on keeping on, you know, making these fights at 25. I don't care. You're extending that record forever ever, and nobody's ever going to beat your record. When they go back in the record books, are they going to ask about, oh, well, were these guys the best ever? How many years was this division there before he dominated it? No. You just look at stats. It's always about stats. What's the most like comedic thing everybody says about Babe Ruth? Well, he was a great baseball player when there were black people in the sport.
Yeah.
You know? But everybody just looks at the stats. You know, and this is what DJ is. He's before we get these dominant, like, new breed of fighters in there. And that's not a big deal. But I agree with you. Dominic Cruz should be his focal point right now.
I tell you what, when you just now said I don't care. I'd stay at 25. It made me hate you for a minute. Maybe that's a good idea. Maybe DJ should just be like, fuck you guys. I don't care. I'm going to stay at 25 and beat the piss out of everybody because I'm so much better. I would fucking despise him. And it would be like the Floyd Mayweather effect. Like, you cocksucker. You cocky little cocksucker. Come on, 125. Go scour fucking North Korea or some shit.
Can you imagine, though? DJ just toying with everybody. Yeah, you know what? Maybe I'll book a fight with Dominic Cruz, and then he's like, nah, never mind. I'll take on Henry Cejudo again or somebody else. Like, for you, he's just going to talk on like that.
It could be interesting because then what happens if you got, like, you know, Dominic being like, well, fuck that. I'm cutting to 25. I'm coming for you, DJ. I'll pull off some extreme dehydration and come for you. I don't know. Listen, man, all bullshit aside, DJ's the man. He is a fucking first ballot Hall of Famer for whatever that means in our punk ass sport. He is a legend, no doubt. But I'm a fight fan, man. I'm a fucking real fight fan. And I fucking hate these people that are like, you're not a real fight fan if you don't appreciate what DJ does. Man, fuck you. I do appreciate what DJ does. But me being a real fight fan, I want to see DJ pushed. I don't get the fucking willies for a fight without dog. Ray Borg didn't have a snowball's chance of hell of beating DJ, man. Nope. Come on. Nope. We fucking knew that. I bought into it with Ali Bagatinov, the Russian with a little bit of power. And I bought into it with Timothy Elliott, the quirky guy with the wild transitions. Bullshit. I bought these stories. These cats ain't on DJ's level. Take that puncher's chance shit, throw it out the window. DJ's on another level. I want to see that man get tested. And if he wins those fights, mark my words, this shit is on wax. We are on it. I will eat these words. If he comes out and stops Dominic Cruz or wins the belt at 35, we will revisit this discussion and DJ will get all the praise in the motherfucking world for me. I'm just not ready to go there just yet.
All right. So,
go ahead, Jesse.
No, then my question would be, who would you consider the pound-for-pound best then? Because now the discussion turns into that, right? Is DJ the best? Is DC the best? Who's the best?
DC.
Man, right if, now?
For me, I got DJ at 2 and DC at 1 because John's a cheater. So DC's undefeated 2 in my book.
Okay, so, well, how about this, man? Okay, how about this, Fred? So DJ also fought at 135. He moved down to 25 when it was available, has dominated it, and has proven that he's able to beat people that are on the juice. DC wasn't able to beat a guy on the juice twice.
Apples to oranges, young man. He might have beat some people on the juice. Ali Bagatinov is not John Jones, man. I mean, John's fucking John. He's already great, and he's on the juice. He's got 2 fucking brothers in the NFL. I almost feel like those pricks were made in CRISPR. Jesus Christ Almighty. I've never seen a fucking family with better genes. Wow. You know what? That's a talking point in and of itself. Either A, they're all on steroids, and they have been since they've been 12, or B, John's the biggest moron in the world because clearly he does got physical gifts. I mean, you don't end up with 2 brothers who both are in the NFL by fucking sheer coincidence, man. Clearly, all you motherfuckers are athletically gifted as fuck. What the fuck are you doing taking PEDs and risking it, man? But that's a topic for another day. Right. DJ is not the living goat. Not yet.
Okay. All right. Look, it's a fair point. Now, here's what I think about this whole going up to 135. I remember the days of the UFC when you had I keep forgetting names now. Hoist Gracie, fighting against like massive dudes that he had no business like fighting. right? I'm not saying go back to those days, but that's kind of what we got into MMA for, to see who could beat who, you know what I mean? Depending on their discipline and everything. Maybe go back a little bit to that and, you know, have to see if DJ wants to fight 135ers. Now, everyone is talking about the Cruz fight, including Liam here says, DJ versus Cruz, I'm dying to see. And, Mike Thompson saying, you know, laughing at your diet Pettis comment. That was pretty good, actually. Joy Tremendous says, DJ needs to go to 135 unless he wants to do a bunch of reruns. That's very true. Raider said, DJ's never fought a champ because he's always been the champ. I like the Cruz fight. I think we all want to see the Cruz fight, man.
I think that's the fight that we all want to. Now, listen, if Dominic beats Jimmy Rivera, then it's even better. But I stand by the fact that even if he loses, I think people, maybe there's a lot of Joey Tremendous, or what's the homeboy's name, Joey, that just got?
Joey Tremendous.
Maybe there's a few of them out there. Maybe y'all just don't remember, dog. Anderson Silva had a lot more of a mystique than Mighty Mouse does right now during his reign. And if y'all forget, when Anderson went up to 205, he fought James the Sandman Irvin. Now, he thunderstruck James and made it look easy, but he didn't go up and fight, he went on to fight Forrest Griffin and make that look easy too, but he didn't even get the Forrest fight first. So if Dominic did lose to Jimmy Rivera, I think it's still a very suitable test for Mighty Mouse. It's a guy he lost to, and you know what I'm saying? Like, no matter what, that's the fight. That's the loss. It's the only loss that DJ's got on his record that he needs to get back to. It's the perfect next fight for him.
Hey, yeah. Ed, can you look up real quick the salaries? Because I'm also going to point out this.
Yeah, I'll look at it real quick.
If you're getting paid less than most of the people on the card, and you have the clout that DJ has, are you willing to put that mystique that you have around yourself as being a dominant guy and moving up to a division?
Here's because the thing. He has no clout right now. He has no mystique. Not really. Not no real mystique. Not like Anderson had. He needs to go up and finish Dominic. Then the mystique will be. What clout does he have? Nobody even buys his pay-per-views.
As being an undefeated champion that has the most title defenses. But here's the thing, Fred. Let me ask you this. If you're a guy that's doing a job, and I ask you, hey, come do this harder job for the same price, are you going to do it? Even though you're very good at your job, and it's a job that is going to test you a little bit.
But that
are you going
to
do it?
It's apples to oranges. The only way that comparison works is that if I do your job right, I get that job and it's worth more. It's not a fruitless attempt. If DJ wins that fight at 35, then he becomes a money fight. Dude, the weight divisions aren't the problem, huh?
No, but is that, like, here's the thing, though. Is that a guarantee? Because
nothing in life's a goddamn guarantee, Jack, but I mean.
No, but I get what you're saying, but you also have to look at it from the perspective of DJ. He's been doing this for this long, and he still is not getting paid what other champions are getting paid after their first fight. But wait.
Ding, 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 ding. Which is why he needs to take that big fight and get his clout up.
But just because you take another fight and you beat this guy, does that mean the UFC is going to be like, well, DJ, here comes the money, baby. You're the next Conor McGregor. We're going to start paying you.
It ain't about
the UFC. That's not true either.
It ain't about the UFC. It's about us. It's about the people that spend that money. If DJ goes up and smashes Dominic, I'll actually want to spend money to watch DJ fight Cody. And that's all the UFC cares about. If DJ can actually – listen, DJ's got the talent. He's got the hardcores by the nuts. If he can go up and start building a rep – that's the thing. People always say, well, DJ's not going to be Conor. I promise you he don't have to be. Fedor was nothing like Conor, and we still speak of that man. It was because of the way he fucking got down, the way he fought, who he fought. Them fights against Nogueira are the reason we still ride Fedor's dick. Fedor ain't been good in the month of Sundays, but he took big fights against top competitors when it mattered. If DJ comes out and fucking, let's say, hypothetically, for the sake of argument, let's say Cody beats TJ and Cody stays the undefeated 100. Let's say he knocks TJ out on some crazy shit. And let's just say that Mighty Mouse fights Dominic and finishes Dominic. and we lined up a huge champion versus champion fight at 35. Mm. And while we're having this hypothetical, let's just say that DJ finishes Cody. Woo. After that, DJ becomes something different, man. And even I will be that guy like, yo, fuck a Connor. You know, DJ destroyed 25. You know, that's, I'm sorry, but that's what we need for, that's what I need to really be like, yo, bow down to DJ, cocksuckers. Cause, you know, look, you can tell in the stare down, he is noticeably smaller than Dominic. But if he can go fucking beat those guys and prove that his technique is that supreme, shit, that's hard to top for anybody. Yeah.
Check this out for as far as people got paid. This is not included bonuses, right? Like, you know, Fight of the Nights and performances. Tony Ferguson cleared $500,000. Nice. Kevin Lee, $250,000. Demetrius Johnson, $370,000, no win bonus. But I don't know. Jesse, tell me, or either one of you guys, did you guys hear if he got, I think this is the first pay-per-view he got actually points for?
He got points for it, yep.
Okay, so I mean, so he got, so he probably, I'll say he probably cleared $500,000. Probably. Probably for the first time ever.
Like, well, he does get some endorsements too, right? As a champion, the monster, and yeah, the Reebok. I mean, I know it ain't much, but I mean, he probably got about a half. Yeah. Probably.
Yeah, and then I mean, what's up?
But again, like it's an economic thing, right? To me, it's like I see DJ's point where he's not making the money. So what is it? What is he going to risk moving up, just to please people that may not even buy into his stuff? Because I understand the Freds of the world, and you know, the people like us that are fans of this sport and want to see him tested, want to see true greatness attained, right? We want to see the John Jones of the small guys, right? Because that's what he could be. But does that translate to the Bud Light fan, or actually the Modelo fan, tuning in and be like, I want to see this guy fight? To me, that's not going to sell, man.
Yeah, real quick. The Modelo is a much better beer than Bud. I just got to say that.
Of course, a Mexican would say that.
Hey, try Modelo. I tell you, Modelo.
It is. It is. You're Light. Right. I agree. I don't like none of that piss, really, but you're right. Modelo is better than Bud Light, generally speaking. But yeah, you know what? Point. Hold on, though. I think you're wrong, Jesse. I think you're wrong, dog. Listen, when did Connor really blow up? When did he really blow up? After he knocked out Jose Aldo, yeah, man. Aldo. Once he slept the king, that's when people were like, oh, like he was big, yeah. But when he slept Jose, let Mighty Mouse come out and sleep Dominic in the first round. Just I know it's crazy, but let it happen and watch. Yeah. I mean, even amongst the casuals, watch Mighty Mouse blow up all of a sudden.
Now, the Uncle Hank's better. Uncle Hank's drinking, but Uncle Hank makes a really good point. He said Demetrius is 5'3", Cruz is 5'8". You're asking a lot.
No, that's not true either.
No?
No, because look at Frankie Edgar. He dominated 155. He never cut weight for 155, and he dominated way bigger guys than himself. So the height is not an issue, man. DC is a small heavyweight and a small light heavyweight, and he throws dudes around. I mean, there's prime examples of short dudes that are able to handle tall people.
Listen, that's a good point. And beyond that, Mighty Mouse is held to a different standard, man. He's held to a higher standard. Mighty Mouse is not other guys. Mighty Mouse is 5'3", but God damn it, he is a mouse who is mighty.
Oh, man. I like how Bruce Buffer went with the Mighty Mouse. He didn't say mighty, you know.
Mighty shit. Whatever. Child, please.
I don't like it either. Just,
you know. Dustin Diamond is still Screech from Saved by the Bell. Jack, you are Mighty Mouse for eternity, little dude.
Shit, there you go. All right. Raider says, yeah, I wouldn't mind seeing DJ fight Rivera. That would be fun. Ooh. You know what? Yeah, there's a lot of fights. Look, there's a lot of fights there for DJ. It's whether he wants to take them or not.
And listen. If Uncle Pappy's drinking partner is goddamn it right, And DJ goes up and gets brutally knocked out by Jimmy Rivera, fair enough.
Okay.
We'll all shut up. He goes back down to 25, and I'll never mention it again. And he can own out, you know. Then we'll know. Weight divisions exist for a reason. The power doesn't translate. And DJ will forever be the king at 25 for eternity. But we still need to know.
Yeah. Meanwhile, our buddy Jeremiah from the Hardcore MMA show says Rivera shocked the world. It's very possible, man. Because you know who knows what Cruz is. Yeah. Not to mention Cruz gets injured quite a bit. So even if they made the DJ fight, you know what I mean? You're still like waiting and on pins and needles a little bit, right?
A little bit, so, yeah. That's true.
Yeah,
that's true.
Yeah.
But so in a perfect world, man, it's the one dude who's got a win over him. I'd like to see DJ go up to 35 to get that real test. I just think that Dominic Cruz is such a interesting, cool fight for DJ at this point.
For sure. Now, here's a good question before we move on to Ferguson Lee. John Smith says, why can't DJ make them come to him?
Because of what Fred's saying. I'll take this, Fred. I'll take the Fred angle. He's not a draw. He's not the red penny in that. He doesn't have that clout that I'm talking about yet. So nobody's saying, hey, I got to go make sure that this guy has to have a challenge and I'm going to go to him. It's more like, well, I'm kind of popular at 35. He could come to me and fight me. Like, it's not a cyborg thing, right? It's not like we need to test this guy right away. So it's just that problem.
Well, I also think that you could also put it in the light that, you know, DJ's the king. They don't deserve the fucking just a quick shot at 25. Like, DJ can go up and do what he wants because he just set a record. Cody hasn't even defended the belt. Dominic's not the champ. TJ's not, you know what I'm saying? Like, if anybody deserves the accolades to go up and wait or to get two belts, it's DJ. I don't, you know, fuck that. They don't get to come down and take a stab at his belt. He should keep his belt at 25 and then go try to get two belts. He's the one that deserves the chance to you know, cement himself in history here. Nobody else is really on the cusp of that. Cody's cute, but like I said, he hasn't defended the belt once. You know, all of them are still kind of teetering. DJ's the one on the brink of greatness.
Yeah. Raider says DC was heavyweight at one point and his short ass was fucking guys up.
There you go.
Look, there's a lot of different ways you could take, you know, we can argue on this one for sure. But like, I mean, my main point is there's plenty of fights for DJ to take. It's whether or not, one, he wants to take him, and two, he feels like he's being compensated enough to make that move, right?
And listen, here's the bottom line. There's nobody at 25.
Yeah, there's nobody.
If there was some kind of animal, a Russian animal at 25 or something, he's just, DJ's cleared it out. There's nowhere else to go at this point.
Yeah.
We haven't seen the Israel Pettis fight. And the Russian guy that he was talking about got slept by, Yeah, Rivera. There you go. So.
And Sergio Pettis has lost that fucking 25 too. I'm so sick and tired of hearing about Sergio fucking Pettis, to be honest with you. Like, that dude ain't no fucking challenge to DJ either. Just because he's Anthony Pettis's little brother and he looks okay against shitbirds, can we stop it with the Sergio Pettis? He's a year or two away from even being remotely close to fight fucking DJ, man.
And at that point, DJ might even be done, or he might have moved up by then, so you never know.
Yeah, I don't think Sergio's nowhere near ready, man. Love it to be a soldier. Must make things.